You guys have fancy garages
too?
The next town over, Winter Garden, has tons of.
Yeah, let me turn on all of our stairs.
Just the fluffer.
We're gonna have to go fire.
Are you ready to be goggle guy?
Yeah.
And the new crew's up. Seth, I don't know if you want me building your goggles.
You gotta learn how to wash them.
Seth, I don't know if you want me building your goggles.
I used to have my own goggles in here.
Probably, yeah. Yours is a little different, right?
You're up, and it's even harder because you get pretty much roll-offs every time.
I never ran them.
Really?
I still don't. I hate roll-offs.
Hey, how about the Supercross collateral before the season?
What?
Does that take very long? You know all the that they show in the beginning of the show?
No.
That just takes a few minutes?
10, 15 minutes. Mm-hmm. And it's always in like a box trailer.
Oh, really?
And it's a super crazy setup, but it looks nothing like a WMT.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay, just cross your arms.
Yeah.
Put your hands on your hips.
Smoke.
Yeah.
Are you gonna wear your mouth guard this year?
No, I'm gonna take it off.
Yeah.
How many do you go through a season? You lose them?
No.
Really?
We really backwards.
It's a big joke on my team. Like,
just to let us
who gets the mouth guard
right,
out of
right,
right there.
It's like it's like the job that no one likes. Because I always take it out. It's full of stuff, and then I'm just like, you.
Oh, who has the
hole?
Yeah.
I don't see it.
Yeah, no, I'm probably gonna, I might just come out from behind
your city
before we operate.
I just didn't feel like getting this too much work. I was so hungry, I just wanted to eat. I didn't want to do all the work. And
Can we get a little higher?
Yeah, I was gonna say, we got more legs.
It's the best wings out here.
Oh, you guys went to it last night, but evidently you got boneless wings. It's called Gator's Dockside.
Gator's Dockside.
It's like a Florida. Yeah, I mean, that's someone who adds a chicken wing.
Yeah.
Come on.
Where do you get boneless?
What?
Where's boneless?
That's a chicken nugget, so I'd go to Chick-fil-A.
Wow. Chick-fil-A. Do you have Raising Cane's out here?
No.
It's California, they know.
Yeah.
Damn, all this machinery.
Did they send you extra clear lenses? Fluffer.
Look out
of your right shoulder.
Cotton candy, dude. Fluffy.
Whatever it takes, dude.
Cool. You go back the other direction for us?
I think I heard your neck crack.
Okay, look down at your gas cap and then do the same thing. Just slowly look up and then look over your right shoulder. If you could put your hands on the grips, yeah, and just do the same thing. Just give us a look to the left and a look to the right. This way.
Yeah.
Okay. And you.
Yeah. Is this for the Supercross commercial? I'm assuming.
No, it's just for
launch.
Getting creative, just for the launch of this new product category for us and
Power Bomb Goggle.
The Power Bomb and the Power Core. Yeah.
That's cool. Yeah. Now start at that position, then kind of look up and look back over your shoulder.
How many goggles are you making around the back?
16 colorways.
Oh shit! You're not dipping your toe in the pool. You're just going all in.
16 colorways, two different lines, the Power Bomb, the Power Core, and each goggle comes either with a clear lens or the mirror lens option.
Mm-hmm.
And the cool thing is the Power Bomb line comes with all this integrated nose piece that can be removed. So yeah, we've got some fire going on here.
Is that a dipped on decal or is that like paint it or something.
I don't know. I don't know how they do it, man. The guys that at 100% that designed this for us was they know what they can and can't do, so it's pretty.
I would think that FMF would have one with like two stroke smoke.
Yeah.
On the frame.
That's like kind of like everything we did. Like we tried to add like the metal look to like the packaging, and you know, and obviously like the Americana type theme where you know FMF's made in America, so. Mm. You know, okay. Have some stars and bars going.
And put those on for a sec.
Do you have a goggle routine?
Not really. Just stack as many as I can before moto.
How many do you use in a motocross and a supercross?
Normally outdoors I would go like either 20 or 28 depending on the stacks, and then supercross normally 14. But I'm pretty picky, like if it gets one spec I'm pulling it, so it's important for me to get the whole shot or I'm going to run out of chances.
When's the last time you pulled all of them on accident?
It's been a long time, but like C-class? In Europe I would run 7 on the bottom on the right side and then 21 on top, and then once I ran out over here I knew I had 7 left, so I just have to really take my time and be like cautious and take care. But now I'm a little bit more experienced and don't really pull them off that often.
Remnants have changed it everything, huh? Because you could only run like 6 before.
Well, I'm not that old, like come on.
Have laminates been around your whole career then?
My whole pro career, yeah.
Yeah.
I think I got them like, would have been like my super mini year, I think.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, that's massive difference. So.
I'm not that old.
Yeah.
Do you remember when we were magazine guys thinking, we'd never go digital?
Oh yeah.
Film is pure, digital's lame.
I remember. Those were the good old days.
Yeah. That was when there was like 6 guys in motocross that could shoot a good photo.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. We had budgets and we could travel and
Yeah.
who did you use the most back?
Yeah.
You shot most of your own stuff, right?
I shot most of my own stuff. It was me and Garth. So back from Utah, we left earlier than I thought. Because Yuki like pooped in the cabin and the smell woke me up. Anyway, back home at Skyline, had some daylight left, so I wanted to take this thing out for its maiden voyage on the home trail. And there was like 9,000 cars at the bottom of the hill, so chances of a hiker hiking up or downhill are probably pretty good. So. Okay, it's Monday and we're at Carson Mumford's facility up in Apple Valley doing the Moto Concepts Honda poster shoot for these guys.
Yeah, I'll be out of spec, bro.
Huh?
Get yelled at.
Out of spec? You gotta have a Leah hat now?
Cooler likes to get his own bootleg hats made and wear them around. Ah.
The ones at the mall kiosk?
Yeah,
get some embroidery.
He's got a guy or two. Let me get in spec. I gotta get in spec.
Grab me one of the hats.
From OGL. Did you see the sparkles?
Hey, can you hold on a second? Mike Shane is lost. I
got to
tell him.
Keep hanging.
Is that the
right hat?
Okay, I'm in spec now, guys. I'm in spec. Go ahead and check that out.
I lost
him. I don't want to get in trouble.
Let me, yeah.
Get a payroll deduction.
Are there fines, huh? Yeah. Fines.
Can I call him real quick?
Yeah. Steph Slattery from Leah. Got all the team gear.
Good morning.
Morning. How are you?
Phenomenal. How are you?
I'm doing all right.
I hate how you sneak up on people.
This is what they're wearing today, huh? So this is called the African tiger?
Yeah.
And there's no tigers in Africa.
There's no such thing as tigers in Africa.
There's lions. Okay, what's new? What's new? What's new?
No, go to like.
Those two are new.
And that's new.
Factory Wrench. What is Factory Wrench?
That's a question for Tony. Oh, I had a feeling you'd be making it out here. I know. You know why? Because you heard she was coming. You heard she was coming.
You're right.
Aaron, what's Factory Wrench?
Factory Wrench is, they make a lot of cool little parts and tools. Like, they're the titanium T-handles you're going to see all in the pits this year.
Mm-hmm.
And then they make a couple other things. Like, they got, like, they 3D printed me, like, some transmission jigs just to sit there when I'm working on it.
And so it's a moto-specific
tool company. Yeah, they have, like, basically, we could tell him what we want, and he'll make tools for us, and pretty custom stuff, yeah.
Do you have any tools with you here?
Nick, do you have the sprocket holder?
Oh. Sprocket holder?
Yeah,
it's so you can choke your sprocket. Oh, shit. Hold the sprocket.
Yeah, so you can put your half-inch ratchet right there. Uh-huh. You can do your 13 on one side, 14 on the other side, and you can hold it in there, and then you can stick your socket in there to torque it while it's on the bike. It's pretty cool.
The cool thing, don't forget to tell them about the titanium T-handles.
Oh, yeah, I did.
Titanium.
Do they spin faster than steel ones?
I think they're just more precise.
Yeah,
right? They're more
titanium's
precise.
Harder, right?
Yeah, so, they're more precise.
Yeah.
It's pretty good stuff.
We got Cole Tickle over here. We want him to ride the bike 10 laps any way you want, and then I'm going to put you on a new tire of tires, and I want you to ride it 10 laps my way. We'll see
what
the lap times are.
We got you on a set of matched tires.
We got you on a set of matched tires, Cole Tickle.
So tomorrow,
you're going to freak Furley up.
Oh, you guys are dressed. You ready.
You just clicked off of it. I see.
Tony, what was it?
I was on.
Who's first? Shane's first.
Yeah, Shane's first.
You're the African tiger. White tiger.
First.
For this one, are they going to go?
I know that you roll, bro.
Can you do that, Shane?
Do what?
The tiger.
Tiger.
For real?
2 days in a row, too.
What are you gonna get? Zucchini burger?
Dining my life right now.
Look at that
chicken. Where's
the goddamn? We're at SDG today. Getting a cover put on Scrub Daddy's bike. There's the cover master. Is this a secret that you're doing here? Tape the sides? Is that a knee brace durability thing?
It just keeps the foam from wadding up underneath the cover. Ah. Like a little dirty sock stuck under your seat.
So, what makes SDG covers better than all the rest? Is this the only one that we use? We had great luck with all of them.
Yeah, we used the same material that Thor used in his hammer, so.
Yeah. And then, do you actually sew them, or do you have them sewn someplace? Because I know you're handy with that singer. Is that a singer?
No, it's actually a wheeler.
Wheeler.
That thing is as old as me.
Yeah. I remember my mom had a singer. And when she would flip the switch to turn it on, it would have that hum. Before she pressed the pedal, the burn.
Yeah, the boom.
And that brings back, like I hear sounds like that once in a while, it brings back childhood memories.
Yeah, the flux capacitor.
Yeah.
Fluxing. So we sew most of our covers in-house, yes.
In-house.
Yeah.
So, do you sew this one?
Yep.
How many do you sew in a day?
Me, personally, I try not to sew that many, but...
do you have staff here that
does
it?
Yeah, we have staff that sews. We have warm machines on over the offices.
Oh.
So.
I've never seen that. Never seen that side. It's not Rona that's doing it, right?
No.
No. Your wife's the bookkeeper?
Yeah. Rona doesn't sew.
She didn't even hem your daughter's pants up shorter?
No, I would do that.
You do that?
Yes.
Oh. So you don't sew, Rona?
Not as good as him.
Yeah?
I can sew, but
so
she
like
puts me to shame.
Who sews the Halloween costumes? I lost a bet one time with my wife, and I had to make a Pikachu costume for my daughter.
Uh-huh.
So I went to N-Style, and, you know, the seat cover department back there. I was like, can I use that machine? And the ladies were just laughing at me.
Oh, yeah.
But it took me about an hour and a half to make just the hood.
Oh,
with
yeah.
With the ears. But
I can't sew like he does. Nope.
Mm.
I mean, I have to break out the instructions to thread the machine.
So I just pulled the cover off Scrub Daddy's seat. Man, I can't believe what the foam looked like underneath. What does that guy do with his seat? It's like all those chicken farts. The new worldwide headquarters of Bill's Pipes.
Oh, look
at that. And there's no sign out front yet. Yeah, how are you, man?
Hey, so you probably like that van a lot, huh?
Oh, I love it. I love it, it's good. Can't drive by schools though. In a van.
Yeah.
Well, let's see the new digs, yeah. Man.
Oh, the new digs they're just pretty squeezed in here and
yeah.
Back to work.
Brandon Dunn.
Back to work.
Hey, Kay, what was your nickname from the guys? Chili Gums? What does that mean?
fuck. Most guys don't know, but me and Chanel and a couple of our other buddies, my buddy's mom made some chili for us one time and we were drinking, I got sick, and I was throwing up chili out of my nose and my mouth, so.
But why is it gums, chili gums?
Because it was all over my mouth, and it was fucking oozing out everywhere.
Chili dog.
Dude.
How you been, Donnie?
I've been good, good, good. Dizzy.
Yeah.
So where's the crew? Is it just you guys? Or are they left?
We got two.
Uh-huh.
So we got the other side too, where Brandon just came out of,
uh-huh.
And that's where our guys, so it's just me and Brandon right here.
Yeah.
The other four are over there.
Okay, I saw one of your guys at Asterisk one day.
Yeah.
The little Chippy. Short guy. Yeah.
Chippy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Does he still work for you?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, they're all over there.
Oh, does Asterisk make your end caps?
They do.
Your carbon end cap?
Yep.
Cool.
Yep. So, man, it's not put together yet.
Was it hard to move all this stuff?
Hey, you should see Bill's backyard, man.
Full of stuff?
Oh, my gosh. Everywhere.
Yeah?
Everywhere.
So old Butch, is he retired now officially?
Yeah, he's only been here 5-6 times.
Uh-huh.
He's just got to take care of my mom.
Yeah.
You know.
So like I say, Brandon and
is
I
this
are
your
right
office?
Here. The other guys are over there.
So it's kinda.
What is this toilet paper on your table?
With what?
It's toilet paper here. Those guys. That's Team Xerox, man. They copy everything I do online. Shout out to Daryl. These guys think they're slick. Tagging my van. That orange pipe. Scrub Daddy's bike. So we filmed one show today. Got old JB, Justin Brayton in.
You're gonna be taken care of.
Been asking for years.
Throw some sets of gear on the rig. Yeah. I literally got in the middle of it via. Dude, what are you doing, dude?
Vlogging.
Get out of here.
No, I'll put that.
No, you can't.
Oh, no, I won't put that.
It was
the log life.
Yeah. See the helmet.
Check that out. It's a dude, good looking lid right there.
The pink looks good.
I like it. Yeah, pink is
a good logo. Really good. So the cross is the Muckoff logo, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep. Muckoff logo.
Dude, it's crazy. I first heard of that brand in Japan. There's a distributor there.
Oh yeah.
I think it's called Dirt Freak.
Yeah.
But yeah, they had a huge display at one of the nationals, and I was like, "What is that pink stuff?" Yeah. And it's soap. But yeah.
I'm pumped because
it's a rad brand.
Yeah, they're huge into bicycles and stuff too. So.
Mm-hmm.
Be cool to be a
part. Oh, fly helmet.
Fly helmet.
Fly. Are you wearing fly goggles too? Head to toe. Fly goggles. Everything.
Yep.
Everything. So. Let's see the helmet, the goggle, actually. Is it
the goggle's awesome, actually. Yeah, I was pumped. That's some good foam. Yep, head to toe. Well, not toe, but Garnet boots.
Garnet boots, though.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
new look.
New look.
What's Mongrel boots?
Mongrel boots is like work boots out of Australia.
Uh-huh.
So, little track walk action.
Ah, okay.
The mechanics are stoked because they're super comfortable. So, yeah.
Well, hey, thanks for coming on the show, bud.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah. It took what, 4 seasons or something?
Yeah.
Worth waiting for.
Not in SoCal very much anymore. East Coast guy, so.
True. But, all right, we'll see you in Texas in a couple weeks.
Cool. Sounds good.
10 days. Yeah, we're at the gas press launch. What do you think of these tunes, Chase?
I've been trying to understand them for the last hour or so. Yeah. I think it's the same song on repeat.
It makes me want to like...
Headbutt something?
It makes me want to light candles and put wax on myself. And,
yeah.
And bite the heads off bats.
Bats, yeah.
Yeah.
That's how the coronavirus started right there. This song.
Pork chop.
Pork chop. Some things never change, hey. Do they? I feel like I should take this down. What's up?
I have one question.
Yes, sir. My car hoppers?
Are those shape ups?
No, they're not shape ups.
They're not?
Dickhead.
They look like shape
they're
ups.
They're not shape ups, you dick.
So tell me about this
These are
bag
my running
company.
Shoes.
What's the bag company?
Albeck.
Albeck.
Yeah, Albeck.
A-L-B-E-C?
A-L-B-E-K.
Okay.
It's a company out of Australia.
Mm-hmm.
Good friends of mine that I've worked with for a lot of years in my past role with other companies.
Mm-hmm.
And they've worked with TLD down in Australia for a lot of years as well.
Mm-hmm.
And a few years ago, they put the wheels in motion to start this bag company.
Mm-hmm.
It's taken a little bit of time to get off the ground, but we're excited to do a global launch as of December 1st.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of face of the brand right now is Toby Price.
Yeah.
He's killing it over at the Dakar. And you know, our next venture is the TLD Gas Gas teams.
Cool. So is it gear bags, travel bags, all
of the above? Yeah, gear bags, travel bags, backpacks. We've got some stuff on the mountain bike side as well, mountain bike shipping bag.
Mm-hmm.
We've got some other cool stuff in the works.
Well, mountain bike travel bag.
Yes.
Oh.
Yeah, full downhill.
You know who you gotta have.
I know who I gotta hook up next time he takes a trip to the Bahamas or something.
Yeah.
Right?
So when were you gonna see these bags?
I'll have product landing here the 1st of February, and then you'll start seeing some stuff. We've got some sneak peeks of some sample stuff here for riders, it'll be available.
Show me.
It'll be available in a little bit. They got to pull it out of the ring.
Oh, okay. So we'll check them out in a bit.
Yeah.
All right.
How's it going?
What is Wow Wow?
Wow Wow, it's the little waffle company.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. Yeah, I actually haven't tried one yet, but I heard they're delicious.
Is it like a protein waffle or is it just like a...
I think it's definitely a healthy waffle.
Uh-huh.
I don't know, you're gonna have to double check once I get one. I gotta get my hands on one, honestly. I'm starving right now. I could eat 3 or 4 of those.
So I'm looking at the rig and there's Sony Pictures, and is that Atari?
Atari.
Atari Hotels?
Yeah.
Is that Atari like Atari...
Like the game?
Space Invaders?
Game, Atari? The game, yeah, Atari?
Yeah.
Yeah, yep.
Okay, so where is there an Atari hotel, in Vegas or something?
Man, I don't know. Hopefully with one of the Supercross rounds I can stay in one.
Yeah. Sony Pictures though, what's the deal with that? Like, we're gonna see some movie graphics and stuff down the line?
Yeah. My dad is good buddies with a few guys over there, and we've been talking, trying to put something together, and they've been helping us out. And yeah, we got some cool stuff in the works. Mm-hmm. Some stuff that this next year is going to be pretty exciting. I can't say too much about it, but no, we're all looking forward to it, and everything's been going good as far as working with Sony, and they're, you know, a great group of people to work with.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, you'll have to check in again.
So the important question here is, has Max Lee converted to a gas yet?
I got one sitting in my shop, but I haven't ridden it yet.
Oh.
No, not yet, not yet. But yes, I will be converting to a gas for sure. Planned on doing a handful of off-road races, whatever weekends I can race,
mm-hmm.
that's available, and yeah, doing a ton of riding and getting on the gas.
Silky, you look good in red, dude.
Red's good. Huh? Red's my color.
Yeah?
It's always been my color, just this is the better red.
Hey,
this is the fun red.
Let's see the helmet, dude.
Oh,
it's gotta be so cool to be.
No. This ain't my race helmet.
Yeah.
But this is freshy.
Are you gonna get frogs on your new one?
No, we got something cool.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, a little Bam Bam character guy for Houston will be pretty cool.
A little BG character?
Oh yeah, something like that. Yeah.
So are we gonna see on the Endurocross track today?
No,
no?
Zero chance.
Come on. Have you done a lap?
Yeah, I rode the trials bike, but I didn't really do a lap.
No.
No, I won't go over. I'm smarter in my old age, or more scared. Ready?
Just pulled up at Blackmore Ranch to do a photo shoot, and look who's riding the mini track. Guys in my driveway. What? What are you wearing?
What, man? Who? Him or me?
You. Why are you wearing a jersey?
I had time to change.
Dude.
This is what I rode to the track today.
You left the track like 3 hours ago.
And I went home, ate.
You already had your chicken and honey.
Yeah. And then I was messing around, and then I got the call from you. And, man, it's a lot of traffic.
And you're still wearing your jersey.
Yeah, I ain't gonna change it till I get home.
Man.
Yeah.
Hey, you wanna know what's crazy? Hey, you wanna know something crazy? That bike on the left is worth more.
I believe it.
That's dumb, huh? Right here. I'm gonna throw your Red Bull stand in the trash. You could have that one.
Thank you.
You're gonna have to change your name to Spoiled Daddy. Huh?
Oh, 21. Spoiled Daddy.
Scrub Sassy, Spoiled Daddy. Well, thank you for loaning us your bike.
Hey, thank you guys for hooking it up, man. Oh my God, look at this.
The seat cover. SDG is the best seat cover you get.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
Yup. Dude, grip and everything. Hey,
yeah. I gotta ask you though, what is this ghetto ass stuff on your frame?
Oh yeah, TP, man, for toilet paper.
No, that.
Oh, I don't know. I can't get it off.
What?
I'm gonna put some gray one there.
Oh, you know, your feet ain't ever eating on the pegs anyway. I don't know why you need grip.
Yeah, because I'm trying some new stuff. You come on, man. You know, brothers then, always got to try something new.
And then you had like a sticker right there.
Yeah.
What's this sticker right here?
I don't even know. People was at the races, so they was handing them out. So
and you put it on your fork.
Yeah.
You don't put a sticker right there, dude.
Why? What happened?
The only sticker you ever put there is like the one from the tuning shop that says the clickers. I mean, you might as well put your green sticker on your fork.
Hey, but wait a minute. What about the sticker back here in that one? In there?
Yeah, that's goofy, too.
I mean,
backyard's tight, but that's a goofy place for it.
That's a good spot.
No. And what is the sticker on your swing arm?
That's
iPhone.
What's iPhone? Man, y'all put that on there, huh?
iPhone. No, you did.
Yeah.
I peeled off that funky swing arm sticker you had.
iPod. Hey, I almost caught a coupon, huh?
Coupon? Hey, so you gotta let me know how this pipe works.
How to what? Oh, all right. Dang, that thing is sick. Oh my God, I can't wait to hear it.
You know who I got that from? Chili Gums.
Who the hell is Chili Gums?
Chili Gums, Brandon.
Yeah.
Your brother.
Yeah, B-Money.
Huh?
Yup. Dang, yeah, Brandon hooked it up, dog. All right. I'm stoked. I'm pumped.
All right. Hurry up, load the bike for my neighbors to call the cops. Yeah, man, I ride. Got a sketchy deal going on in the parking lot of Stater Brothers.
So what we got going on?
New media looks project?
Like we're, looks like we're making transaction deals. You got me my slides, my Gucci slides right now. I just got a random guy taking pictures of me. Yeah, I don't know where we are. We're just making deals happen. My little guy right here. So... I don't know, just getting ready for the season. I'm excited, man.
How things going?
It's been going good. Been going really good. And I feel like these last like 3 weeks, the whole Star Racing Yamaha team on the 450 side, everybody stepped it up, and the bike's been good. And I don't know, man. I feel like the guys on the 250, I can't say who's gonna be racing the coast, but they're looking good. We're all looking good. Like I said, me, Dylan, AP, Christian, Colt. Even Justin Cooper coming back. Everybody's looking really good. So,
have you ridden with Dylan yet? Because he's back now. But
yeah, no. Dylan,
I know
he
does his own thing.
I mean, Dylan, honestly, I know he had a big crash that was at Elsinore. It doesn't look like he even left the track, honestly. It doesn't look like, he looks really good. Everybody's looking good.
I asked him. I said, hey. I was texting him. I go, hey, dude, I heard you're hauling ass already. And he goes, oh, you're listening to all the bullshit. I'm just trying hard.
He's riding good. Like I said, I think Yamaha's got a pretty good, strong 450 team, and I'm excited. You know, we only got a few more days of racing, or a few more days of practice. And it's going to be a weird one, though. I ain't going to lie. I'm still devastated that it's not the typical A1, what I mean? You still get the A1 chills and media and stuff like that, but at least I should be thankful that we're actually racing, what I mean? With everything that's been going on, so H1 it is. Here we go.
Do we have a walker back there?
Yeah.
Fuck.
Ah, fuck, sure. Is that Steve's brakes? That part is so sick. So we're at Glen Helen today for the first Swapmoto Live race of the year. We had 600 pre-entries. It's gonna be psycho. We got Kenny Taco Bell in the house. Look at him in his leisure suit.
Oh, you know, we're built for comfort out here.
DBK.
You know? Hey, we just talk. Kadari already talking good. Shit.
Hey, you know what? Kendari's not on his regular ride. You're gonna wax his shit today. Ooh.
You know, half the battle's just feeling good, you know?
So, give me some predictions. The great Vet Pro race class battle between the 14
look
of
at
King
this.
Taco Bell.
Here comes the drunk himself.
Yeah.
He's probably got a beer already. Got a driver already. Yeah. His dad's probably driving his ass. He's the wild card. You got to watch out for the old number.
But the rivalry is 102 Kendari, isn't it?
I mean, I feel like this rivalry got built up by like this company called, what is it? It's a new company, Swapmoto Live. I think that's where this whole thing came from. But yeah, I mean, the boy, he always seems to get me. But I'll be honest.
You've been training.
I think I'm going to hit him today.
You're going to get him.
I'm just going to hit him.
You're going to hit him.
Yeah.
Hey, don't bend my bike too bad. He's racing my KTM. So Dahmer moving up, back up to 40 intermediate today.
No,
I already talked to the promoters. You're sandbagging in the novice class.
I'll load up right now.
Oh, jeez. Here we got our bike. Oh, she's looking a little worse for wear. I got a new graphic kit and a new plastic kit at home. Because Dan the Dirt did me dirty. But, so I got a Tapia sticker from my homie, Scrubby. And I just found out that my good friend Hitoshi in Japan was diagnosed with colon cancer. So we're gonna ride for him today. It's not a very good five. There we go, that looks better, I guess, but anyway. Hitoshi, stay strong, you can beat it. And look forward to riding with you at some track in Japan again soon.
Hey, Ray was in your sweats the other day.
Hey, he kind of looks like a garden gnome, huh? Little bit? What do you think?
A little bit.
I'm pretty sure A-Ray was wearing
those
sweats.
He looks like a tie-dye garden gnome.
Say Medusa's lit kit.
This is bullshit.
So what do you think? Are you confident about taking down the chalupa and on your loner bike?
On the pumpkin?
Yeah.
Yeah, loner bike is gonna get it. We're gonna get him.
You're gonna get him? You're gonna tell him Your bike, any bike, you got them covered.
It don't matter
right?
What bike.
Yeah.
It's just a bike.
You can't get a let a guy with a mullet beat you.
No. And sweats, matching sweats.
For real, look at the sign up line. How are this many people waiting in line? Times like this. I'm cutting. So Aaron, dude, how many pre-entries do we have?
It's like over 580 pre-entries for this race. I mean, we've been trying to push people to pre-enter, but this is a great turnout. 2021 season kicking off right here at Glen Helen Raceway.
So pre-entries are usually like 75, 80 or something, right?
Actual riders, yeah. But I mean, our pre-reg numbers have been in the 200 to 300s pretty regularly. But this is double that. This is record-setting for us, yeah. Even back to the Transworld days. This is record-setting.
So it is A, an amazing program, but B, do you think it's also a little bit of this COVID and people want to get out and race?
Yeah, I mean, I ended up starting my own little amateur team because of a bunch of kids who played soccer and baseball and they can't play anymore. So
yeah.
These guys that have been riding motocross now for just 6 to 8 months are out here racing the Swapmoto Race Series and having a great time. It's actually the biggest class that we have. 65 beginner class is the biggest class here. We've got divisions in 4 different classes today. It's
nice. So how's Regan's fame meter doing since he's been our gas tester?
His head still fits through the door, but barely, just barely. Yeah, he's pretty pumped. He's he loves going to school and telling all his friends at school what he did.
Oh, nice.
Pretty rad, thank you.
See the pre-race rituals. Team Way. What's he doing?
Draining the gas. Some new one in there. Stuff.
Is that oil gas in there? That's taking it out?
Yep.
Is that gas no good?
To be honest with you, I accidentally put straight gas in it yesterday, then I just dumped in some premix. And now it's not running great, so you know, I'm just gonna start from scratch.
I did that once and my dad was so mad at me.
Well, I mean, it's probably not wise because this bike's been sitting for a while too, so maybe the gas and the carburetor, it got gummed up, but I mean, we got some time, let's figure it out.
All right. So is the gas in those jugs from USA gasoline off of...
No, but that gas was dialed back. Yes. Off Flint Keith?
Yeah, where I saw you getting gas that time. I was like, you are on a factory Kawasaki and you're buying gas at USA Gas?
Absolutely. It's good.